Hello students, I am Ankit Gupta. Today I am here to represent you a topic, completing square method. This method is used to solve the zeros of the quadratic equation. I am taking one example for solving the quadratic equation, and by which we will find two zeros of that equation. Please see everyone. First, we will take an example, 3x square plus 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation on which we will do this method. So, first step, we will do this method step by step. So, first step, make the coefficient of x square. Make the coefficient of x square as 1. So divide by 3 in both sides. 3x square upon 3 plus 2x upon 3 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 0. Now solve that expression. X square plus 2x upon 3 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 0. Now bring the constant in right side. So x square plus 2x upon 3 plus equal to minus 5 upon 3. Now take the coefficient of x, 2 upon 3, multiply it by 1 by 2 and take as square. Now what is it? 1 upon 3 square, and it is 1 upon 9. Add in both sides. Add in both sides. So x square plus 2x upon 3 plus 1 upon 3 whole square is equals to minus 5 upon 3 plus 1 upon 3 whole square. Now this will become a complete square. What is the meaning? X plus 1 upon 3 whole square is equal to minus 5 upon 3 plus 1 upon 9. Why we are calling it completing square? Because we are making a square, and that square has done. Now the left hand side is completely solved. Now we will solve right hand side. X plus 3 whole square is equals to minus 5 upon 3 plus 1 upon 9. Now take the LCM of that step. LCM is 9, so minus 15 plus 1. X plus 1 upon 3 whole square is equals to minus 14 upon 9. Now square will go in right hand side. So X plus 1 upon 3 is equals to minus 14 upon 9 under root. Now this expression cannot be solved. This expression cannot be solved. So the quadratic equation has imaginary roots. Why? Because in the under root there is a negative term has come, so the roots are imaginary. Now pause the video. We will take one more example in which we will do the completing. 3x square minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. In this equation, we will apply this method and we will find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. So we will do this question as step by step. So first step is make the coefficient of x square is 1. So how to make it? We will divide 3 in both sides. So divide by 3 in both sides. First step. So 3x square upon 3 minus 5x upon 3 plus 2 upon 3 is equal to 0. So solve it. X square minus 5x upon 3 plus 2 upon 3 is equal to 0. Now second step is take the constant term as in right side. So x square minus 5x upon 3 is equal to minus 2 upon 3. Now take the coefficient of x. Only take this coefficient. Don't take it the sign. 5 upon 3. Multiply it by 1 by 2. Solve it. 5 upon 6. Now take as square. 5 upon 6 whole square. Add in both sides. Now x square minus 5x upon 3 plus 5 upon 6 whole square is equal to minus 2 upon 3 plus 5 upon 6 whole square. Now see, in the left side a whole square has done. So how to make it? First we will write as x, then we will write this sign as minus, then we will write this 5 upon 6 and make it as whole square is equal to minus 2 upon 3 plus 25 upon 36. Now we will solve it. X minus 5 upon 6 whole square is equal to, take as 36 as a LCM, so 12 2s are 24, minus 24 plus 25. So X minus 5 upon 6 whole square is equals to 1 upon 36. Now this square will go in right hand side. So x minus 5 upon 6 is equal to under root 1 upon 36. When we will write under root, then we have to write plus minus sign. So x minus 5 upon 6 is equals to plus minus 1 upon 6. Now we will take as two part. X minus 5 upon 6 is equal to 1 upon 6. X minus 5 upon 6 is equal to minus 1 upon 6. So solve it now. X is equal to 1 upon 6 plus 5 upon 6. So X is equal to 6 as a LCM, so 1 plus 5. So X is equal to 6 upon 6 is equal to 1. So one coefficient is one constant and one zero of this quadratic equation is 1. Similarly, we will solve this also. X minus 5 upon x is equal to minus 1 upon 6 plus 5 upon 6. So x is equal to 6 as LCM. So minus 1 plus 5. This is 4 upon 6. Now it will cancel 2 and 3. So x is equal to 2 by 3. This is the second zero of this quadratic equation. Beta is equal to 2 by 3. This is called a completing square method by which we can get two zeros of the quadratic polynomial. This is a specific method. If the question says to solve this method, then you will use. Otherwise, there is no need to use this method. But this is a very simplest method for solving any quadratic equation. So thank you all of you. Further, in the next class, we will discuss about the new method. Please like this video and subscribe the channel also.